Thanks for joining us and welcome to PA Sports Talk. I'm Ed Gottlos, along with co-host Joel right here. We're now in the first full week of the high school winter sports season. So here we have our first basketball game of the week on Friday, and it's Chambersburg Boys hosting Harrisburg Boys at the Cassius Fieldhouse at 7:30. Since the Trojans lost 55-52 to Central Dolphins tonight, this game takes on even more importance because they don't get too far behind in the division standings.
Yeah, Coach Treffler talked about a tough early season schedule, and it's playing out this week. He predicted CD and Harrisburg to be the top two teams in the division, and they found out some good things Tuesday night that, you know, if they can play with CD, who's the second best, that means they should be right there in the mix. Had trouble with some height. They had Devin Thomas score 34 points on them, and that was kind of a concern coming into the year. So how they handle not only Harrisburg's quickness, but their size inside will be a big key Friday.
Yeah, I guess that Thomas kid's supposed to be one of the best players in the league this year, I guess.
Yeah, if not the best in the state. So Harrisburg always comes in with enough athletes to kill you. So Harrisburg's going to have to take care of the ball and make some three-pointers, because inside they're struggling a little bit to find some consistency right now.
Yeah, so they had, 10 three-pointers against Central Dolphins, right?
I think 29 two-point shots and 26 three-point shots, which is something Sean wanted to get away from this year. So it's still early, and their strength is their guard, so at times it's going to be like that. But they got to get the ball inside somehow for easy baskets.
Yep. Also, Friday night, you have the annual rivalry. Greencastle is going to host James Buchanan Boys. Those two teams, I guess, are, you know, still in the hunt, obviously, in the Colonial Division, so kind of a little bit of leg up for anybody to win this one.
Yeah, watching JV Tuesday, they have a lot of individual talent, but right now the mix hasn't come together for them yet. And Greencastle's got a new coach and, you know, a bunch of new players, so we'll see how that plays out. But, you know, one thing you'll notice, those teams will play hard against each other, and, you know, it won't matter when in a rival game like that.
Yeah, and the gym will be packed. That's another prediction. Top two girls games Friday. You know, the opposite of that, we have Greencastle Antrim playing at James Buchanan. And I think, the other game is Gettysburg at Shippensburg. I think most people think that's the game that might decide, you know, who's going to win that division. But Greencastle JV winner could still be in the mix a little bit.
Starting with Ship, they played Gettysburg in the tournament, and Gettysburg was missing two starters. I'm not sure if they'll be back Friday, but that could be an interesting to see how they compare without their starters versus with them, because Ship has a team that was all sophomores mostly last year. Now they're all juniors, and that's supposed to be one of the big leaps you take as a high school player. And Ship's dominated their first three games, and it's too bad they're quad A this year, because they look to be like they could have done some damage in triple A, but this will be a good test for them because Gettysburg's also quad A.
And the thing to keep in mind in that game is that the opposing coaches are like best friends.
Right.
You have Megan Carr at Shippensburg and Casey Thurston at Gettysburg, and they played together at Shippensburg.
Casey's dad was the coach at Shippensburg,
right.
Bill Ray. So.
Right. Very interesting. And I know that that Megan's been keeping track of Gettysburg's injuries a little bit too, to see if those girls are going to play. So
right.
They don't really have a lot of secrets there. Okay. Thanks again for joining us for Sports Talk. Have a good week and enjoy the games.